Hello, my little frogs and froglets. FairClone49 here, and I am here with another Blight video. So, as you can see, I have Call of Brine, Overcharge, Make Your Choice, and Blood Warden on my Blight. I constantly run this all the damn time because this is the, I'd say, in my opinion, for my Blight, is the best build that I can pretty much bring. Because I will tell you what these perks do in just a moment. So, Blood Warden, if you don't know what it already does, as an exit gate is opened, Blood Warden is active. Once you help a survivor after downing them and all that stuff after the gate has been opened, the entity blocks the exit gates, both of them, for 60 seconds, which grants you another minute to be able to down and kill any other survivors that are within the exit gates trying to save each other. You can sometimes, not all the time, get these survivors by surprising them with Blood Warden, because most of the time they do not know that a killer has Blood Warden unless if you pretty much make it obvious. I try to make it not as obvious as possible so then I can get that surprise of, hey, it's Blood Warden. So, it always works. I'm also running Make Your Choice, which if you don't know what that does, Make Your Choice if you are 32 meters away from the hooked survivor, it is pretty much active. Once that healthy or injured survivor has saved the hooked survivor, they are granted 60 seconds of exposed status effect, which you have, as Blight, obviously, you have lethal rushes. If you hear a survivor scream, you can lethal rush to that location of the hooked survivor, and down the other survivor that was screamed and get another hook. I have done this multiple times. I have done this a few times in the two games that you are going to see. As just sometimes I just can't make it to that survivor because of the map, but most of the time I do end up getting to that survivor that has screamed, and it does work in my favor. So another good perk that I'm running is Overcharge, which will be combined with Blood Warden, as you will see. So Overcharge, obviously we already know that Overcharge has a difficult skill check that the survivor pretty much has to face if they interact with the generator, and if they fail it, it gives an additional 5% loss progress. But if they succeed with that skill check, then there's no progression lost. But if I apply Overcharge now, which it was in this update, obviously the update has been out for, I think, 2 to 3 weeks now, if I'm not mistaken. So obviously we know that Overcharge has an increased speed of 75% of normal to 200% of normal over the 30 seconds for regression. And this combined with Call of Brine. Call of Brine has a 200% of normal regression speed, is just about 400. So this regression is pretty good for gen slowdown. And with Call of Brine, Call of Brine is active for 60 seconds on the generator and it lights it up with a yellow aura, pretty much telling you that, hey, I picked this gen, so this gen is either regressing or a survivor is on this gen. And once it gets to 90% or 70%, or for every good skill check or great skill check that the survivor is doing on the gen, while that gen has a yellow aura on it, you are granted a loud noise notification from Call of Brine telling you that someone is on that gen, and you can lethal rush back over there to get that gen and give it another Call of Brine and Overcharge, which works every single time. There is no cooldown on either one of them. You can keep applying Call of Brine and Overcharge, which is pretty OP for a gen slowdown. So the add-ons that I am bringing on my Blight is the Alchemist Ring and the Soul Chemical. If you don't know what these do, these two add-ons are the best to run on Blight once you have gotten down the practice and the all that stuff that you are trying to master with Blight is pretty hard. So, yeah. So the Alchemist Ring, if you don't know what that already does, once you have hit a survivor with a successful lethal rush, you are granted all of your rush tokens back, and you can lethal rush back to that survivor after you have hit them because of the little speed boost that they always get. So, you were pretty much a unstoppable blight. So the soul chemical grants you a difficult skill check to the healing and or repairing on a survivor if they're 16 meters away while you are rushing to that location. Obviously, it does not trigger for a survivor in range at the start of the rush, but if you are rushing to a generator while they're on that generator, you pretty much give that survivor just one, I do believe, it doesn't apply to all of them, a difficult skill check to for them to either fail or hit, and then it regresses the gen by 10% automatically. So that is pretty huge, especially if you are being overcharged and out of time for another gen slowdown. So I am done rambling on for now, so let's get straight into the gameplay.
Ah! Yeah!